Hello everyone, I'm Zulu Ecojedo, a caregiver student trainee, and today I'm going to perform on how to take a vital signs. A vital signs is a clinical measure used by the health providers to check the patient's temperature, the pulse rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate to confirm a health status condition. And this time, go with me and I'll show you the tools, equipment, and supplies needed to take a complete vital signs of the patient. The first thing that you're gonna do is to gather all the supplies needed in checking the vital signs. To start with, I will show you the tools and equipment and supplies that I'm going to use in checking the blood pressure, the body temperature, the pulse rate, the respiratory rate, taking the blood sugar, and checking the oxygen saturation. First, I have here the blood pressure apparatus. It consists of a blood pressure cuff. It is a rectangular shaped cloth being wrapped in the patient's arms, and it has the inflation bulb. It is a rubberized bulb shape that is being pressed in order to sustain air going inside the cuff. And this is the sphygmomanometer. It measures the arterial blood pressure. Next is the stethoscope. It is a Y-shaped equipment being used to listen the pulse and the heartbeat of the patients. And the stethoscope has different parts. This is the airpiece, the air tube, the binaural spring, the tubing, the stem, the chest piece, this is the bell, and this is the diaphragm. Next, I have here the pulse oximeter. This device is used to measure how much oxygen is in the blood. Then I have here the thermometer. This device is used to measure the temperature or the temperature gradients in or the hotness and the coldness of an object. And lastly, I have here the blood sugar device, which consists of a glucometer. It is a finger grip device that is used to measure how much glucose is in the blood. The lancet device, a small tube device that holds the lancet to launch in the skin to make a puncture that produces a blood drop. A lancet. It is a small plastic device that securely holds a needle to poke the skin or fingertip to get a small drop of blood. And next, the test strip. It is the key component of blood glucose testing, wherein it is being inserted in the glucometer and where the blood is.
And for today's video, I will show you how to use your thermometer. Thermometer is used to measure your body temperature. Body temperature is to measure how your body can make and get rid of heat. The normal range of an adult temperature is 36 to 37.2 degrees Celsius, and for the children is 36.6 to 37.7 degrees Celsius. Right now, I have a digital thermometer. Digital thermometer can be used by three ways: axillary, orally, and rectally. Then, how to use thermometer orally. But first of all, we need to wash our hands or sanitize our hands. Clean the tip. Put the tip under your tongue, close your mouth, breathe by your nose, and wait until it beeps. Hi everyone, right now I will measure my blood oxygen by using pulse oximeter. Pulse oximeter is a measure of how much oxygen is in your blood. Pulse oximeter have two readings. The upper part is for oxygen saturation and the lower part is for pulse rate. An ideal pulse oximeter reading is considered normal when your oxygen saturation level is 95% to 100%. Values under 95% is considered low. Okay, before we start, we should wash our hands or have sanitize. Then, warm up your fingers. Make sure that you sit properly. You can use your index finger or your middle finger. Position the probe correctly. And start. If you have nail polish
on the meter, this white and black end portion of the strips must go inside from the meter. And here you go. Next, bring the alcohol swab and clean the fingertips. Then wipe with a clean cloth. Then start poking the fingertips to take blood sample. Press the fingertips. Wipe out the first lead as it might contain an alcohol from the alcohol swab. Then press the finger again and transfer the lead into the strips for you to have a reading. Wait for some seconds to give us the reading. Now, my blood sugar is 126 mg/dL and it is normal. After taking the reading, remove the test strips from the meter and discard the strips from the waste bin. And also remove the lancet from the lancet device and discard those waste in a proper waste wherein an hazardous and infectious waste belongs. Then don't forget to document your reading. Wash and sanitize your hands as well as the device before storing in the storage place. And that would be all for today. Thank you and keep safe.
Thank you for watching and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the button so that you will be notified every time I'm uploading a new video. Thank you very much and God bless.